Then, today we'll be learning about the concept of the operator overloading. Previous session we have dealt like which are the types of overloading concept, operator overloading concepts which are said to be present in C sharp. In this session you will be learning about the various loadings, how they are said to be used, okay, overloadings, how they are said to be used, and through an example you are said to be learning. Okay, so let's check out with the various operator overloadings. There are three types already you know. One is unary type, another one is binary type, another one is comparison operator overloading type. All these types are there, and let's check how they are said to be used. Okay, let's check means what you are said to be checking one by one, how it is said to be dealt, and what you are said to be doing within the concept. So operator overloading. First one, you say the unary operator overloading. It's nothing but it takes only one argument. Remember, whenever the output is being considered in the unary, it may accept two, but at the end it will be accepting only one as the output. Okay, so here you can check out two variables are there, x and y, which are taken as int in the class bank. Okay, in the bank you are said to be taking two variables a and b, and those are said to be initialized to x and y. So a default constructor is there. Here you can check out no values are being passed in the bank. Okay, public bank. Public is nothing but is it said to be available everywhere. Okay, public void display, it only displays the values of x and y. Okay. So in the next part here you can check out, okay, here in the static operator, a bank operator, another method is there where you are said to be passing your unary operator, which is said to be initialized to minus. Okay, when it is initialized to minus, in here you can check out both the values of x and y are said to be initialized to minus. Okay, both are said to be initialized to minus. So in the main method, whenever you are said to be calling the values, so a object is being created called bal, through that bal you are said to be calling the values of x and y. Okay, x and y values are said to be 10 and minus 20, and those are said to be initialized. And the display method, what does it consist of? You have seen here, display method consists of, it is said to be displaying one just the values of x and y. So here it is said to be, in the output you can check out, it is said to be only displaying the values of x and y, that is 10 and minus 20, which are being taken. Okay, now bank, another object is being created for the class bank, okay, BA2. So BA2 dot display, BA2 dot display is nothing but the second method which is being called of the bank, which doesn't have any values. Here you can check out, this is your second method which is being called without any parameter. So since it doesn't have anything within the method, what will happen, it is said to be printing just nothing, no values are being printed in the BA2 dot display, so it will be 0 0. Okay, next, BA2 is equal to minus bal. Minus bal is nothing but when I put the value of minus here in the bal, it is minus 10 and here it becomes plus 20. Okay, BA2 is nothing but, minus bal is nothing but, it's the opposite of bal. It is considering the x and y value with minus. So minus 10 and 20 is the output. Okay, what is the output? It is minus 10 and 20, that it will be displayed on the screen. Okay, this is the output of the unary operator, where you are said to be using the values for only one argument which is being considered. Okay, next you will be moving on to a concept called as binary operators. So binary operators are nothing but two variables which are said to be assigned with certain values of different data types. It may be of type real and imaginary type when you are said to be considering. In this example, the binary operators, you are said to be just printing the value. So you can check out here, x is said to be int and y is said to be double, and complex numbers, it is said to be having the real and imaginary part. Okay, so x is said to be real and y is imaginary. Okay, when you consider both of them with the operator, okay, binary operator plus, it is being using two complex numbers are there, c1 and c2. So complex number, for that you are said to be, for the class you are creating an object called c. So c dot x is nothing but c1 dot x plus c2 dot x. C1 dot x is nothing but whatever value is being specified in the real and the imaginary part, it will be considering for both x and y values. So when you consider the same, and the value is said to be written. So here when you consider in the show part, you are said to be showing the output. You are printing X, you are printing Y, and in between you have the J. With that it will be printing the output. Okay, so here in the main method, variables are being taken, that is P, Q and R. So P is nothing but it is printing the real and imaginary part. P is said to be printing real imaginary part, and Q is also printing the real and imaginary part. So it is, in the beginning it is said to be 10 and J2. It's nothing but this one, 10 and J. J is being considered and 2. Whereas second one, 20 and J15 point. Fine, it will print in the P part, Q dot show, and R, R is what, P plus Q. So P plus Q both are said to be added and it will be printed. So added and printed is nothing but it will be of the format, you have P plus Q. So it will be 30, 10 plus 20 is 30 plus J 15 and 2. Okay, so you have 10 plus 20 is 30 plus J 15 and 2. When they are said to be added, both of them, it will be taking the values of imaginary part. So it has 15 minus 2 is nothing but your 13.5. it will be considering as the output. Okay, so this is your real and imaginary part in the binary operators. And last one is your comparison operator. Comparison, you all know, less than, greater than, less than, equal to, greater than, equal to, not equal to, equal to, all those are being used. In the example you have taken with three variables X, Y and Z, both three of them it was said to be considered in P, Q and R. So P, Q and R, when you are said to be considering the vectors part, you have to observe whether it is said to be equal or not. When the comparison is being considered, either it will be returning either true or false, or it may be equal or not equal. That concept is being used. So here you are considering the two way separate paths, that is V1 and V2 vectors. In that you have three values, that is X, Y and Z. So both of them, if V1 dot X is equal to V2 dot X and V1 dot Y is equal to V2 dot Y and V1 dot Z is equal to V2 dot Z, when all are said to be equal to each other, then it will return true, otherwise it will be returning the false value. Okay, so in the Boolean aspect, you are said to be, if it is not equal, both of them, vector 1 and vector 2, it will be printed returning not equal to V1 and V2. So in the vectors, both are said to be passing the values here. In the V1, you have 10, 20, 30, and V2, it is said to be 40, 50, 60. When you compare it, V1 equal to V2, you can consider both these XX values, these YY values, and these ZZ values. Both are being considered. Since both are not equal, it will be printing not equal. When both are said to be the same, it will be printing both are equal. So output would be not equal. Okay. So this is the concept of all the three operator overloading concept. One is said to be your unary, second one is binary, and third one is comparison operators in C sharp. Okay. All these are being considered in the operator overloading. Okay, this session will be ending with this operator overloading. Okay, thank you.